Yo, what is up guys? Welcome back to a brand new video. I'm really excited for today's video because I think it's going to be a really interesting one and maybe controversial, so I might get canceled. I don't know. But yeah, in today's video, I'm going to be discussing my unpopular rap opinions and just talk about some stuff that I think that other people might not like and stuff like that. I think it's going to be a really interesting and fun video. So leave a comment down below if you agree or disagree with any of my opinions. Please subscribe if you guys like this video and leave a like too. That would mean a lot to me. And yeah, guys, enjoy the video. Alright guys, kicking off this list is the inspiration to make this video. It's very controversial, but I'm going to say it anyway. I don't think Lil Baby should be featured on every single song in the world. I know, it's crazy. Please don't cancel me. Please don't flame me. But that's just my opinion. Now, don't get me wrong. I do like a lot of Lil Baby songs. Close Friends, Emotionally Scarred, Some to Prove, Whoa, Drip Too Hard are all bangers. But sometimes his style and voice doesn't really fit with the vibe of a song. Take Back At It by Lil Mosey. Now, I was vibing with that song. I was listening to it. I was enjoying it. And then I heard Jack Jordan. What is that? What is that? That doesn't really fit with the whole vibe. His sound doesn't fit with the vibe of it, so yeah. I don't have a problem with Lil Baby as an artist. He's just on every single album, and I'm getting tired of hearing his voice. Alright, so this may or may not piss off a couple of Fortnite kids, but in my opinion, Ransom is one of Lil Tecca's worst songs. Now, I'm not saying it's bad by any means. I do think it's really good, especially the Juice WRLD one, but all of his other songs are way, way better. They're way more catchy, they're way more fun, they're way more vibey, the lyrics are better, the beats are better, the flow is better, just everything about them is better than Ransom. Shots, Amigo, Molly Girl, Love Me, they're all more fun and catchy than Ransom in my opinion. I like the beats more, I like pretty much everything about them more. It's kind of hard to explain, but Ransom to me just really feels basic, at least compared to all of his other stuff. Now, I'm not really sure why this happened, considering his old stuff is so much better. Grammy Freestyle, Rags to Riches, Count Me Out, they're all so good, and I'm not really sure why Ransom was the one to blow up. Maybe it is because it's so basic, but to me, all Lil Tecca's other songs, especially on We Love You Tecca, are better than Ransom. And just a quick unpopular opinion inside this unpopular opinion, I think the Juice WRLD one is better than the original one. Juice WRLD has a really nice flow on this song, and he has a really good vocal performance on the song, and I just think he adds to it, and listening to it without him just feels kind of empty. It feels more empty than it already is, so yeah. And speaking on rappers whose most popular songs I think are the worst, we have 24K Golden, and I think Valentino, City of Angels, and Mood are really good. I really do love those songs, but I think Been Here Before, Graham, My Bed, and especially A Lot to Lose and Games on Your Phone are way, way better, and they're really, really underrated, consisting of like hundreds of millions of plays, and the songs I just mentioned have like under 10 million, I think. So I think most of them have under 10 million. And yeah, it's pretty crazy considering that I think they're a lot better. They have a lot better structure and they're a lot more melodic and all that stuff. And they're kind of less basic to me, I guess. And yeah, that's all I have to say about it. So yeah, comment down below if you guys think Valentino, City of Angels, and Mood are better than his other stuff. And yeah. Alright, so this one comes from reading a comment section on TikTok where the guy asks his audience to comment down below underground or underrated rappers. And before we begin, I just want to let you know that I'm not an official who's underground, who's mainstream decider, whatever you want to call it. I'm just giving out my opinion, and pretty much my opinion on being underground is if your biggest song is a million plays and under, I would consider you underground because you do have one little mini hit, but you don't have many songs with over a million plays and you're not very well known. But the comments that I saw just kind of gave me a headache, to be honest. Most of the comments I saw were The Kid Leroy, Bankroll Hayden, Lil Tecca, Chef G, Sleepy Hollow, Polo G, and Lil TJ, and I kind of get where they're going for. Those artists are really new, so they're not as well respected in the game yet, but there's no way I would consider any of them underground or underrated. Sure, they may be underappreciated, but I still feel like they have a lot more time to grow and improve as an artist, and they've only been in the game for a couple months or a year. So, I mean, come on guys, give him a break. Of course, they're not gonna be as well respected as Kanye West has been in the game for 10 years, but I guess I know what they mean. But yeah, as an avid underground rap listener, it's just kind of annoying to me when I hear people say The Kid Leroy is underrated, because he has a song with like 100 million plays. Like, really underground rappers would kill for that many plays, so yeah, that's just kind of where I stand on that. The Kid Leroy, Bankroll Hayden, they aren't underground at all. Okay guys, so my last unpopular opinion, which may get really, really heated actually, is that the new wave of sing rap isn't turning hip hop popish. It's really, really good, and it's a better way to tell your stories and be lyrical than the OG lyrical rap style. I also think that you can't immediately call a song mumble rap or trash because the guy's singing on it, because chances are he is more lyrical than your favorite Eminem wannabe, who just goes abba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da for the whole song. I think telling a story or trying to be lyrical while singing is the best way to do it, because people will remember it more because of your singing voice, the emotion, the pain in your voice, the catchy melodies, all that sort of stuff. It'll stick in people's brains, and it'll actually, and if you're trying to send a message, it would probably resonate more with the people because you're doing it in a more fun way, or at least you're doing it in a more meaningful and emotional way. Most people nowadays think being lyrical is either going really, really fast, like Eminem, to the point where no one can understand you, or going really, really slow and being boring. So that's why most kids don't like lyrical rap, or they think they don't like lyrical rap, because that's what they mostly see. But the truth is, lyrical rap can be really fun, or can be really emotional, or can be really nice to listen to. You just gotta find the right people. And I'm glad that people like Polo G and people like that are bringing more lyrics into their singing, because to me, that's the best way to portray a message through catchy melodies and through hooks that'll get stuck in your head. Don't get me wrong, I do like a lot of old school lyrical rap. I like J. Cole, J.I.D., Boss, Loot, all of Dreamville pretty much. But to me, the new wave of Juice WRLD, Polo G, and for my underground people, Nick Bonin and Aerodaze, I think that's the way to go. Having a message but singing is probably the best way to portray your message if you're trying to be a musician. The singing will make it entertaining and it'll make the lyrical content a lot more meaningful and impactful. And I'm not saying we have to get rid of all rapping. I like the old school stuff, like I said. I also like Detroit rap, New York rap, Bay Area rap. Those are all really good. I'm just saying that I think the sing rap is a new way of being lyrical and we shouldn't hate on it. Okay guys, so that's it for today's video. Leave a comment down below if you agree or disagree with any of my unpopular opinions. This took a while for me to edit and I really enjoyed it, so please leave a like and subscribe if you guys like this video. And yeah guys, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace out. Arabit.com.